For thousands of years, peoples of the First Nations have walked on these lands. As we gather, we acknowledge that we stand on the traditional territory of the Tla'amen Nation. May we live with peace, respect, and friendship on this land. Well, good morning and welcome to a worship service with Powell River United Church. On this Sunday, November the 6th, 2022, we are in the 22nd Sunday after Pentecost. We have a tradition of sharing good news at the start of our service. My good news is that next weekend, my son who lives in Victoria is coming home to Powell River to visit, and I'm very much looking forward to that. Do you have some good news? Maybe you'd like to call someone from the congregation and share your good news today. Some announcements for us. Next weekend, Harmony Vespers is on Saturday, November the 12th at 4 o'clock in the sanctuary. The band that will be playing and entertaining is called Six Ways to Sunday. The following weekend, we're hosting a flea market in Trinity Hall, November the 19th from 9 till noon. The contact for that event is Marilyn Davis. And a few weeks later, there's going to be a community paint night Wednesday, December the 7th from 6 till 7:30 at Henderson Elementary School. And this is a time to paint a brown paper bag that will be used in the Everybody Deserves a Smile project. So we've done that before at our hall on our Advent decorating night. This year, we go and join other folks from the community at Henderson Elementary. So Kate Boyd is the contact and Doe Fraser. If you need more details on any of these, you can call the church office. Let's light the Christ candle. Christ candle reminds us that Jesus is present with us during our worship and that Jesus is the light of our world, the light of our life. Let's share a call to worship. The past is full of memories. The future is full of possibility. The past calls to the future for a word of forgiveness. The future sings to the past of the goodness of God. And now is the time for memories and hope, for accepting, restoring, and understanding. Come, let us worship the God of the past, present, and future. Let's join together with our opening hymn, Voices United, number 395. Come in and sit down.
Come in and sit down. You are a part of the family. We are lost and we are found. We are a part of the family. You know the reason why you came, yet no reason can explain. So share in the laughter and cry in the pain, for we are a part of the
part of the family.
Come in, rest for the weary and health for us all. There's a yoke that is easy and a burden that's small. So come in and worship and answer the call. For we are a part of the family. Come in, come in and sit down. You are a part of the family. We are lost and we are found. And we are a part of the family.
Let's share our opening prayer. Let us pray. Loving God, you who are the center of all being, we begin our worship today with a thankful heart. We call to mind the many ways our lives are made better just by knowing that your unconditional love and acceptance is a part of who we are. May this time together be guided by your Holy Spirit, and may we be uplifted and strengthened in your love and light, so we may channel that love and light into the world. This we pray in the name of the one who is the light of the world, Jesus the Christ. Amen. Our next hymn is Voices United, number 820, Make a Joyful Noise. Let us listen for God's voice as we hear the reading of our scriptures this morning. Our psalm is number 98. Sing a new song to the Lord, for he has done wonderful deeds. His right hand has won a mighty victory. His holy arm has shown his saving power. The Lord has announced his victory and has revealed his righteousness to every nation. He has remembered his promise to love and to be faithful to Israel. The ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Shout to the Lord, all the earth. Break out in praise and sing for joy. Sing your praise to the Lord with the harp and melodious song, with trumpets and the sound of the ram's horn. Make a joyful symphony before the Lord, the King. Let the sea and everything in it shout his praise. Let the earth and all living things join in. Let the rivers clap their hands in glee. Let the hills sing out their songs of joy before the Lord. For the Lord is coming to judge the earth. He will judge the world with justice and the nations with fairness. Our New Testament reading is from Paul's second letter to the Thessalonians, chapter 2, verses 1 to 5 and verses 13 to 17. Now, dear brothers and sisters, let us clarify some things about the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ and how we will be gathered to meet him. Don't be so easily shaken or alarmed by those who say that the day of the Lord has already begun. Don't believe them, even if they claim to have had a spiritual vision, a revelation, or a letter supposedly from us. Don't be fooled by what they say, for that day will not come until there is a great rebellion against God and the man of lawlessness is revealed, the one who brings destruction. He will exalt himself and defy everything that people call God and every object of worship. He will even sit in the temple of God, claiming that he himself is God. Don't you remember that I told you about all this when I was with you? As for us, we can't help but thank God for you, dear brothers and sisters, loved by the Lord. We are always thankful that God chose you to be among the first to experience salvation, a salvation that came through the Spirit who makes you holy and through your belief in the truth. He called you to salvation when we told you the good news. Now you can share in the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. With all these things in mind, dear brothers and sisters, stand firm and keep a strong grip on the teaching we passed on to you, both in person and by letter. Now may our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who loved us by his grace, gave us eternal comfort and a wonderful hope, comfort you and strengthen you in every good thing you say and do. Our gospel reading this morning is from the book of Luke, chapter 20, verses 27 to 38. Then Jesus was approached by some Sadducees, religious leaders who say there is no resurrection from the dead. They posed this question: Teacher, Moses gave us a law that if a man dies, leaving a wife but no children, his brother should marry the widow and have a child who will carry on the brother's name. Well, suppose there were seven brothers. The oldest one married and then died without children. So the second brother married the widow, but he also died. Then the third brother married her. This continued with all seven of them who died without children. Finally, the woman also died. So tell us, whose wife will she be in the resurrection? For all seven were married to her. Jesus replied, Marriage is for people here on earth, but in the age to come, those worthy of being raised from the dead will neither marry nor be given in marriage. and they will never die again. In this respect, they will be like angels. They are children of God and children of the resurrection. But now, as to whether the dead will be raised, even Moses proved this when he wrote about the burning bush. Long after Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob had died, he referred to the Lord as the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. So he is the God of the living, not the dead, for they are all alive to him. Here ends our readings, and thanks be to God. Our next hymn is Voices United, number 365, Jesus Loves Me. Let us pray. Creator God, may the words of my mouth and the meditations of all of our hearts be acceptable to you. Amen. This morning we have scripture readings that pertain to the afterlife. And this is fitting at this time of year, as we have just come through All Hallowtide. This is a new word for me that I learned when I was looking up information about All Saints Day. I learned that October 31st, Halloween as we call it today, was originally known as All Hallows Eve, the night before All Saints Day, November 1st. All Saints Day is followed by All Souls Day, November 2nd. And the collection of the 3 days is known as All Hallowtide. It is a time to think about those who have passed away, to pray for them, and to consider the mystery of our faith, eternal life. I was on Vancouver Island last weekend and had an opportunity to take a friend out for a birthday lunch. This friend turned 70 on November 1st. I was teasing him that in his younger days, which were full of shenanigans, he might not have been considered a saint. He said he had so much fun teasing his sister when they were teenagers, saying, "I don't see any saints associated with you, but all saints are around me. I'm the one born on All Saints Day." Amidst these considerations about people who have died, there is a theme of promised life. And this theme also carries a message that we do not need to be worrying about these kinds of things. God has promised us life. And as Psalm 98 states, all the earth The seas, the mountains, and every creature shall give praise to God for God's wondrous works and God's wondrous promises. In the second letter to the Thessalonians, Paul urges the people to not worry about end times. Quoting from our whole People of God curriculum, what is clear is that the day of the Lord is not coming soon. It will be preceded by evil things, and the church needs to be prepared to live in the midst of those times. Promised life refers both to life in the hereafter and life in the present. Promised life is to be found in the community of the believers, and Paul gives thanks for their faithfulness. In our gospel reading, we once again hear of a situation where the religious leaders of the day are trying to trip Jesus up in his knowledge about scriptural teachings. The Sadducees are the ones asking the questions of Jesus, and they were Jewish leaders who did not believe in the resurrection. They create a scenario of a woman being widowed, having no children, and her husband's brother marrying her, as was the tradition, but having no children also before that brother dies. This is repeated down a line of seven brothers. The Sadducees ask Jesus, whose wife will this woman be in heaven if she has been married to all seven brothers? Jesus explains that in the resurrection life in the spirit world, there will be no marriages. Life will not be as we know it today, here on earth. Don't worry, though. God has promised everlasting life. God has promised that our spirits will live on after our earthly body has died. This everlasting life in the spiritual realm will be very different. There is so much we don't know about what this will be like. There is so much possibility. But we might wonder, given today's reading, if there's no marriage in the spiritual realm, will we not know each other? Will we not be reunited with our departed loved ones? I believe we will. I believe we will know each other, who each other is, and we will know great love between all of us, all the saints, if we want to use that word, all the souls. And most importantly, we will know great love between us and God. Jesus tries to explain resurrection life to us in another way, in another passage. At the start of the 14th chapter of John's Gospel, Jesus says, "In my Father's house, there are many mansions. If it weren't so, I would have told you." In our mind's eye, based again on our limited experiences on earth, we might envision heaven as a huge mansion or castle with many rooms in it. Jesus says he will prepare a place for us. He will come for us. And Jesus gives us a reason for this when Jesus says, "So that where I am, there may you be also." I like to believe in the huge possibilities with that statement, that where I am, there may you be also. When we see God in a beautiful waterfall, or we see Jesus in a summer sunset when the sky is so glorious with colors, when we see God's love as we watch a mother raccoon using her dexterous hands to feed her children, when we feel God's presence sitting with us in the quiet of our prayer time, there, in those moments and places, can also be the spirits of our loved ones. For where God is, there may our spirits also be. This blessing, written by Jan Richardson, captures this idea nicely. It's called God of the Living. When the wall between the worlds is too firm, too close, when it seems all solidity and sharp edges, when every morning you wake up as if flattened against it, its forbidding presence fairly pressing the breath from you all over again. Then, may you be given a glimpse of how weak the wall and how strong what stirs on the other side, breathing with you and blessing you still, forever bound to you, but freeing you into this living, into this world, so much wider than you ever knew. This week, let's fondly remember those people who have been saints in our lives and who are now living in the spirit world, and let us thank God for them. Let's also bring to mind those people who are now saints in our lives, who are living in this earthly realm and visible to us each day. Let's be thankful for the gift God has given us of people, wonderful companions, cherished friends, beloved family members. In closing, I'd like to share a reading from our Whole People of God curriculum. Throughout history, God's people have celebrated not only what God has done in the past, but also the life that God promises for the future. Sometimes promised life turns out to be different from and beyond what we have expected. But God is always in the midst of us, leading us on. Promised life is something we already live, as well as something we look forward to. We can celebrate the ways that God has kept promises in the past, and this helps us feel confident in our hopes for life beyond death. With hope and trust, we say, in life, in death, in life beyond death, God is with us. We are not alone. Thanks be to God. Amen. Our next hymn is Voices United, number 705, For All the Saints.
For the world.
We appreciate the ways that you have continued to support the ministry of Powell River United Church by your online offerings or offerings shared through the mail. Let's have a prayer for our offering this day. We are invited to take part in God's great enterprise of healing the earth, of caring for those who are vulnerable, of building up Christian community. God, let us present our offerings this day as we join you in this great enterprise of love. Let's share together more voices. 191, what can I do?
What can I do?
Let's join together in a time of prayer. Let us pray. Holy One, we pray for the people of this community who are faithfully there for one another in times of joy and sorrow. There are some who are truly singing a new song, and their joy overflows and enriches everyone around. We give thanks for their expressions of hallelujah. There are also some among us who are hurting because of lost or broken relationships of all kinds. Many are in a time of transition and are uncertain of what the next faithful footsteps will be. Help them know you are there in the uncertainty and that it is okay to lean on the generosity of a caring community. We pray for this hurting world that is struggling to endure conflicts and wars, abuses of power, and changing climates. We pray for all those who have been displaced from their homes and who seek shelter on the move. We pray for peace that is built on justice. Help us remember that all things are connected and all forms of life are dependent on each other. We give thanks for the communion of saints that surrounds us and cheers us on in both challenging times and in times of celebration. We acknowledge that we are part of a larger sacred story and that we are called upon to write the next chapter of your faithful people and to sing a new song for our time. Let us pray the prayer of Jesus. Words we are invited to live, each in the language of our hearts. For God is like our mother, and God is like our Father, who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. As we prepare to leave this time and go into the world to share God's love, let's sing about how amazing that love is. Our next hymn is More Voices, number 26, Your Love is Amazing.
Love is amazing, steady and unchanging. Love is
hear these words of blessing. From this place, go out remembering the holy vision. Go to the waiting world. Go out to build God's dream. In this hour, go out with the Spirit of Christ within you and before you. Amen.